All right, folks, today we're going to take a look at the TOPDON Phoenix Lite 2 once again. I did a complete overview video on this scan tool a few months ago, and that particular video was filmed in a 2006 GMC pickup truck. And I just figured I'd make another video showing this scan tool being used in a little bit more modern vehicle. So today we're in a 2022 Kia K5 sedan. It's what the Kia Optima sedan turned into. They just basically renamed it the K5 2021 and beyond. But we're in that vehicle and we're all hooked up here, and I was just thought I'd give you a look at some of the live data PIDs and some of the special functions and actuation tests in a newer vehicle compared to that 2006 vehicle that we previously did the video in. So for like this one here, I got a list of all the modules pulled up. I'm already connected to the vehicle. And for a more in-depth, full overview video, I'll put a link up here or down below. But this video is to just show the scan tool being used on a more modern vehicle. So like, for example, we'll go into the engine control module. And so we'll start with the actuation test first. And this will give you a long list of the different things you can control on this vehicle. You know, as obviously as vehicles have become more modern, there's more things you can control with the scan tool, you know, compared to that old 2006 GMC truck that I was in. You know, you got fan pulse width modulation, EGR, canister purge valve. I'm just naming off a few of these. You can read them as I scroll. You know, injector disable and oil control valve and, you know, turbo wastegate and all sorts of stuff. So then we'll go back. Then we'll go back to special function. And this will do, this will read the VIN and write the VIN. Integrated thermal module, coolant filling mode. And this vehicle is so new, I haven't worked on it yet, so I don't know what half this stuff is. This is just a demonstration. EVAP leakage test. Let's go into read data stream. So every one of these is a data PID that you can select. And so, I mean, I'm just going to scroll through here. You know, AC pressure, accelerator pedal sensor, actual engine speed, lambda value, adapted throttle angle, air mass adaption, you know, it just goes on and on. Battery sensor built in, battery voltage AMS, brake pedal switch, and I mean, you can just keep going on. And these modern vehicles have, you know, dozens and dozens and dozens of data PIDs. Computers nowadays monitor everything. And every one of these is a live data PID. So, for example, we'll select a few of these as we go, a few basic ones. Engine oil temperature, engine speed, fuel level, fuel tank pressure. We're just selecting a few that we'll hit OK, and then we'll see the data PID pop up on screen here. Misfired. I mean, it's a never-ending list. Vehicle speed when maximum RPM is measured. Throttle opening. We'll get down to the bottom here. Vehicle speed. I think I already selected that. There's a couple of vehicle speeds here. One must be in mile per hour, and maybe one's in voltage. Sensor, I don't know. Water temperature. Anyway, then we'll hit OK. And now here we are. Here it lists all of those data PIDs that we selected. Engine oil temperature, 199.4 degrees. Engine is 706 RPM, 81% full of fuel. Fuel tank pressure is -3, -4. The throttle opening, 3.5%. Vehicle speed is at 0. Water temperature is 211 degrees. And, of course, we can graph this, and let me hit the throttle pedal here. Fuel tank pressure obviously is changing with that, and so that's a good look at the live stream. And go back to the module list here and give you another example. Let's see what else would be good to look at. The TPMS. So in this vehicle, I've got, you know, obviously TPMS, tire pressure monitoring system, but it only gives me tire pressure, okay, on the display, on the dashboard. So on this one here, if we went to read data stream, we could see the front left battery level in, you know, in the actual valve stem. It's essentially a radio that transmits data, and that has a battery. It'll tell you the battery level. It'll tell you the temperature of the valve stem or the sensor. It'll give you there's event numbers and ignition cycle count. There's all sorts of stuff. So let's just for fun here, we'll just pick left front battery level, front left temperature, and front left pressure. And there's, you know, there's obviously four tires worth of data here, and there's all sorts of stuff. But we'll just select OK, and it says front battery level is normal. The front left pressure is 31.65. It shows 32 on my dashboard, so this is a more accurate display. And then, of course, I have a temperature, which my dashboard does not display. I got tire temperature, 73.4 degrees. So that's kind of cool to be able to do all to be able to see that. And then also on the TPMS, there's special function. You can do wheel sensor ID writing and TPMS reception rate measuring mode. Not quite exactly sure what that is, but I think it's how often it takes a reading from the sensor. And then vehicle name code writing. So you got to, this has some TPMS ability. Go back. Let's take a look at the ABS. And we'll look at the read data stream first. So this is all in the ABS module. There's some overlapping data PIDs, of course. Inlet valve, you know, your ABS. There should be wheel speed sensors, vehicle speed. There's your wheel speed sensors. I've mentioned that in other videos about your wheel speed sensors. That data is always or usually found in the ABS module. And so there's quite a few data PIDs there to choose from. We'll go back and see what it has for actuation tests. There's a bunch of stuff you can control. Turn the motor on and off, the ABS pump. Let's go back and look at the special functions. So you have air bleeding mode, brake pad changing mode, steering angle sensor calibration. Quite a bit of functionality on these new vehicles. So anyway, folks, I just wanted to give you a look at what this particular scan tool looks like on a modern vehicle. And I may do this with some of my other scan tools also. I mentioned before in my previous TOPDON Phoenix Lite 2 video that this is one of my favorite scan tools now. So, I mean, if you're looking for a scan tool, be sure to check this one out. This one's really good. All right, guys, that's all I have for now. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.